Good afternoon, and thank you very much, Imran, for the introduction. And I'd like to thank Canon for the invitation to speak. These are some of the usual disclaimers. And what I want to talk to you about today is harnessing the power of AI to streamline CT operations and increase efficiency. These are some of my disclosures. Now, I'm going to start with this slide. It's a busy slide. Don't get into the details. And you know, as someone who does AI for image analysis, that gets a lot of attention, and it's great. But we put this slide together, and over the years it has evolved, is to remind everyone that, you know, there's a lot more where we can use AI to streamline healthcare processes than image analysis alone. And honestly, I see those as some of those as really low-hanging fruits, because some of those don't even have the same regulatory burden, and there are real friction points in hospital operations. Now, we'll be talking about CT, and let's be honest, what is CT? CT is the workhorse of diagnostic imaging. And if you're in a hospital, I think I can say very frankly that most hospitals will not function without a functioning CT department, right? Everything will come to a halt. Now, traditionally, when we've been thinking about efficiency, a lot of us just think about MRI. But you know, CT as the workhorse is another area that's sometimes overlooked. And there's a lot of potential for applying technology like AI to streamlining those operations. Now, what are some of the issues? No, one is just the volume. When I first graduated, there was a shortage of technologists. I can tell you all these years later, it's not got any better. That's a real friction point, right? And that has a domino effect, because when you have a shortage of technologists, the other thing that results in is that you have to sometimes get technologists who don't have the same level of experience. This impacts operations. It also impacts quality. And this is really one area where we do have the technology, and as you see, the technology is there and being implemented, where you can address real-world problems that increase both efficiency and quality. And one thing, in the current era, where we have a shortage of technologists, where there's a shortage of radiologists, I like to sort of generalize and say, well, workflow is king, okay? And if we can come with simplified single button solutions, then that would be perfect. Now, let's talk about some current friction points in CT. We can maybe divide these into three major ones. One are inconsistencies and deficiencies in image acquisition, right? So, and this could be from variations between users. It could be lack of experience of the technologies we just spoke about. And sometimes it's not clear because they're inconsistent prior exams. This has an impact because you get lower quality images. Really building on that, you can get on suboptimal image quality. I know this could be really not having enough signal, having too much noise. You can't talk about quality, by the way, without talking about those, right? So those two are related. And what you really want is optimal. You want to give the least possible dose to get the right diagnostic quality. And this is something I would argue a machine is great at. And then lastly, then there's the question of reconstructions, right? I've been doing spectral CT for a long time. And I remember many years ago with one of the vendors we worked with, one of my first comments was, we have to automate some of these reconstructions. People don't have time to make their own reconstructions. Many years later, that hasn't got easier. It's actually worse. Radiologists have more volume. There's a shortage of rads. If it's not at their fingertips, people are likely not to use it in the majority of practices. Again, but the nice thing is we have the technology. And then last thing is this whole pressure we talked about. Diagnostic imaging volumes are constantly going up, particularly in CT. You know, and the technology is being tied up doing some of these steps, takes them away from doing other tasks, so like patient-facing tasks that ideally they should be doing, and that's where we can leverage the machines. So, how do we use AI to address some of these points? So, what I want to do is, let's go through the traditional CT workflow. So, what's the conventional workflow? Like manual positioning of a patient, get a 2D lateral AP scout, acquire the scan post-processing. Traditionally, these were all required a lot of interaction with the technologists. Well, really, you will see now that, and these are not aspirational. We're going to be talking about things that are here now. that a lot of these, now the AI and other technologies are being leveraged to automate some of these, saving you time, but importantly, maintaining, or I may argue, even increasing quality. And again, just like when we talk about image quality, we think of those. When we talk about efficiency, we should think about quality, because if you just get efficiency at the expense of quality, that's not going to do it. That's the sweet spot. That's where I think AI has a real role, because we can really maintain or enhance quality while increasing efficiency. And so let's talk about the first problem we talked about, inconsistencies and deficiency in image acquisition. It may sound simple, but you know, just a user interface, being able to simply drag and drop, having the technologists who may not be familiar with a given scanner, given that they're less experienced, to click on the body part and things pop up, and the next step come automatically. These are technologies that are, like I said, not aspirational, but currently there, that can enhance workflow. Now, let's talk about planning. If you think, does it even make sense with current technology to use a scout to do the planning? The nice thing is now you can actually get a 3D landmark scan, you can get a 3D scanogram with almost the same dose as you got those, having much more information that can be tailored, whether it's from planning perspective, provide more consistent planning, and you know, get you actually a better quality scan. This is dose neutral. And by the way, the same thing can even be used for bolus tracking without additional acquisitions. Building on that, there is now technologies. Remember, these scanners have AI inside, they have cameras. You can now do anatomic landmark detection that's automated. So instead of having the technology spend time, this becomes a zero-click thing where the scanner does it, I would argue, not only increasing efficiency, but actually consistency and quality. And at least in pilot studies, you're seeing all sorts of performance improvements, right? Reduction in time for doing it, more consistent scans, better accuracy in terms of what you're getting, really, again, aligning that idea of maintaining or enhancing quality while increasing efficiency. Now let's talk about enhanced image quality that we can get with current technology. Well, that's where deep learning comes in. We have seen a lot of the diagnostic applications, and this technology is really playing a great role in optimizing reconstructions across all imaging, right? CT, MR. Now the technology is there where, rather than the standard filtered back projection, by leveraging deep learning, you can do denoising that is far superior and actually reduces those. Again, better quality with less dose. This can be done rapidly on top of that, integrated into the CT workflow. And of course, we don't have time into getting a detailed discussion of spectral technology, but this is also going to be key for that, because the same technology that's being leveraged to improve conventional reconstructions is now being leveraged to improve spectral reconstructions, whether it's your virtual mono energetic images, reducing noise, and more material decomposition. And this is technology that's already there and is likely to further improve in the coming years. So keep attuned to that, because there's some really interesting developments in this area. And of course, even now there's technology to use a conventional scan to create very high resolution scans when it's indicated, say, for evaluation of a very small structure. And then lastly, the seamless automated workflow and fast reconstructions. You know, it may be simple, but when it comes to adoption, I've seen nice technologies all the time. I've actually been almost sad. You go to conferences, see all these cool things. You go in actual practice, people don't use them. I can tell you it bears down. It has to have value, but it also has to fit in the workflow. People are too busy. If it's not at their fingertips, sadly, my experience is people will not use it. But the nice thing is these are not customizable. And also, you can get things that are real value. So if you have a conventional CT, for example, getting something like automatic bone removal, getting reconstructions rapidly done that are available, not an hour later like we used to do with the 3D lab, which really doesn't fit in any real current workflow now, but right there without tying up the technologies. This is leveraging AI to enhance operations. And then when you go into spectral, of course, things like iodine maps. Increasingly, the spectral reconstructions are, you can automate, customize, and have them sent. And again, we expect further enhancements in making some additional tweaks that bring this technology really at the radiologist's fingertip without tying down the technologists. Now, we're at the end of the talk. We spoke a lot about scanning, but just remember, the same technology is being really leveraged along the whole end-to-end chain of diagnostic imaging. To get a good scan, it's not just image analysis, right? Someone has to order it, the order has to be right, it has to be protocoled right, it has to be executed properly, and of course, then it has to be interpreted properly in a timely fashion. And this technology is really starting to impact every one of these steps. Even going into diagnostic realm, maybe even flagging things at the scanner if a patient has an urgent finding and the patient needs to stay and not be leave the CT suite, this technology is there and it's going to be further enhanced in the coming time. So in summary, I know I covered a lot, but there's a tremendous potential for AI really to enhance operations through assisted automation workflow in CT. And what I hope the point I hope I got across is that some of these technologies are right there, and you can expect even more improvements in the years to come to increase operational efficiency while at the same time increasing quality of care. And that's the end of the talk. Thank you again, and thanks again for Canon for the invitation to speak.